how important is it to be able to forecast, you know, what your needs will be into the future, into next week and the week after or next month?
That's also a huge part of the mission readiness. And the reason for that, as in the commercial world, in the defense world, the aircraft come through for scheduled maintenance. And those scheduled maintenance actions are really heavily based on part replacement. So to get a better grasp of the scheduled or isochronal maintenance that's coming due, to be able to forecast that and see what's coming in the pipeline for your supply to facilitate the maintenance on that aircraft without holdup would be just fantastic to have. In today's world, many facilities across the globe in the defense market have no way of forecasting what they're going to need. The aircraft get pulled in, they go through their heavy maintenance, they start finding all kinds of issues, and there's no supply or no parts in their supply chain to facilitate that. So the aircraft gets delayed, gets scheduled to the right. This would be critical and would really increase the efficiencies of the mission readiness overall.
Okay, so understanding aircraft, understanding and being able to predict, you know, failures, and understanding your live inventory and being able to forecast, you know, all are important parts of that. So let me just ask this with respect to forecasting then, is that what are some of the factors, Manoj, what are some of the factors that make forecasting, you know, more reliable or successful? How do we make a more reliable future forecast?
Yeah. So, Mark, like I think I mentioned in some of the previous conversations as well, we have to look at forecast across the life cycle of the aircraft, right? How you forecast in the beginning of the aircraft when the aircraft has, let's say, you know, a couple of years of usage versus 20 years of usage and beyond that, right? In the early part of, and there are three elements into that, and they go up and down depending upon what life cycle of the aircraft you're talking about. And those three elements, in my view, are number one is the OEM provided maintenance program for an aircraft, right? Which is very relevant in the early part of the life cycle of an aircraft because of the lack of a lot of missions that the aircraft might have flown and lack of history of the data. But as the time progresses, in addition to that, there's another important layer that gets added, which is based on the historical operational of that aircraft and the need for the parts and the reliability of the parts in the aircraft. Then you start adding that AIML-based predictive maintenance, right? So basically, you look at the historical data and then do some predictive maintenance, and then you layer that on top of what OEM has provided as the base maintenance for a program for the aircraft. And the third is, which is very relevant in today's world in terms of the amount of sensors that get attached to the aircraft and the amount of software that the aircraft has. There's a lot of real-time information that is coming out of the aircraft. You need to be able to tie that real-time information from those sensors into these mid to long-term forecasts and create a seamless immediate need, mid-term forecast, and the long-term forecast. But that's what I think the three elements that come together as part of the total forecast concept, I would say.
Okay, so let me kind of sum that up then. So we get data when the aircraft is delivered. Okay, we accrue operational data through the use of the aircraft. All right, and then because of the sophistication of aircraft, we accrue data, you know, in real time. And so it sounds to me like we have a lot of data that's being accrued. All right, and let me just ask you this: is that how do we turn data into actionable information? I mean, what do we do with that?
Yeah, I mean, there's one thing that really feasts on that data is the artificial intelligence and machine learning capabilities, right? So I think from, of course, our perspective, from Ramco's perspective, a lot of focus and investment has gone into building our AIML engine. But the main thing is, like you said, the data. And it's good, and we're very happy that in today's world, there's a lot of data that we can capture, both the static that is provided by the OEM and all the real-time information that flows in. We marry all of those together and really create near true forecast for the aircraft as well as parts that are needed, not just at one location, but the whole multi-echelon supply chain.
Yeah, I think that's really, really critical. You know, in my experience in working with commercial MROs, I've seen a lot of operations being performed where, you know, data is collected. I see the manufacturer collecting data. But less often do I see that data being used to be able to be interpreted or to be able to be used to manage and change the maintenance program. I mean, you know, David, did you see that in the Navy, in the military as well?
Yeah, for sure. In the Navy and also across the globe in a lot of these depot facilities, they are collecting data. They're using usage details for other aircraft. But unfortunately, a lot of that data just falls into a spreadsheet and goes into a black hole. And there's no way to actually, you know, use that in any fashion to action or look at a forecast for future needs.
Okay, so I see that as being a really important part of optimizing the supply chain and logistics and forecasting and all these things that we've been talking about, is to be able to take all this content or all this data that we have and to be able to turn it into something that's really, you know, actionable. And I see what you're saying, Manoj, is with the artificial intelligence, you know, built into systems today, if we leverage that, we can actually have a much more efficient, you know, system and a much more efficient operation by turning that into actionable intelligence. That's really interesting.